dear children, in the last video lecture, I told you introduction of fraction, what is fraction, how many types of fraction, how we divide into a fraction, mixed fraction, proper fraction, improper fraction, like fraction, unlike fraction. And today we start here the exercise, and exercise 6.1. In this exercise, first question is complete the table. Table is here. This is table. And in this table, first is here, some shapes are given here. First shape, second shape, third shape, and fourth shape. And the second part, number of equal part, how many we write here, how many parts, total equal parts. Now, colored part, uncolored part, and part needed to make one whole. The first question is given here. 3, 1 upon 3, sorry, 1 upon 3, 2 upon 3, and 3. Okay? Now, how many total equal parts? 1, 2, 3 parts. So we write here 3. How many colored part? 1 part. Means out of 3 parts, 1 part is colored. So we write here 1 upon 3. Means total number of parts equal 1, 2, 3. So this is your denominator. Total number of parts equal your denominator. You write here in the denominator place. So 3 parts, 1, 2, 3. So we write here 3. And 1 part is shaded, is colored. So we write here in the numerator 1. So this is the fraction is 1 upon 3. Now, second, third block, uncolored. How many parts are uncolored? 1, 2. Means 2 parts are uncolored out of 3 parts. So we write here 2 upon 3. And total, number 4, part needed to make a whole. Whole means complete figure. So 3 parts, 1, 2, 3 parts are needed to make a whole. Okay? Now the second question. 1, how many number of equal parts? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 equal parts. Colored part, 2 upon 4. Means out of 4, 2 parts are colored. So we write here 2 upon 4. And uncolored part, 2 upon 4 also, 2 upon 4. And how many parts are needed? 4 parts. Now, how many number of equal parts? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 parts are equal. Colored part, 1 upon 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 parts. And 1 part is colored. So we write here 1 upon 4. How many parts are uncolored? So 3 upon 4. Out of 4 parts, 3 parts are uncolored. So we write here 3 upon 4. And 4 parts are needed to make a whole. Now, total question number 4. How many parts? Equal part 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 parts. So we write here 8 parts. And the colored part 1, 2, 3. Out of 8, 3 parts are colored. So we write here 3 upon 8. And how many parts are uncolored? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. So we write here 5 upon 8. And how many parts needed to make a whole? Equal 8 parts. Okay, dear children. Now this question is completed. Now the question number 2. Question number B is divide each square into equal parts, color to show the fraction. Means first question, 1 upon 3, 3 upon 2nd, 3 upon 4, 7 upon 10, and 4th question is 5 upon 8. We, here the children, we divide into these fractions, divide into 3 parts. We divide here 4 parts, 10 parts, and 8 parts. Okay. Now, 1 upon 3. So, 1, 2, 3. 3 parts, 1, 2, 3. And 1 upon 3 means we colored here 1 part. This is the 1 upon 3. Now, the second question, 3 upon 4. Now, divide it. First, we divide here 4 parts, 4 equal parts. This is the 4 equal parts. And 3 upon 4 means 3 parts is colored, should be colored. So, we colored here 3 parts. So, 3 upon 4. Now, next is 7 upon 10. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this 5. 10 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and now color the 7 parts. 5, 6, and 7. Now, we can write here 7 upon 10, because the one whole parts we divide into 10 parts, we divide into 10 parts and 7 parts is colored here. So we write here 7 upon 10. Now the last question is 5 upon 8. So first we divide into 8 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 parts. And we colored here how many parts? 5 parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts is colored. Okay. Now the question number B is completed. Now the question number 3, match the column. Yeah. Now dear children, question number C, match the column. First question is 4 upon 10. 4 upon 10 is 4 is out of 10 parts. 4 out of 10 equal parts. So 4 upon 10 means 4 out of 10 equal parts. So this is this, and we, this is the fraction 4 upon 10. When we write in the word, we write here, we read here 4 tenths. 4 tenths. So 4 tenths, where is 4 tenths? This is the 4 tenths. So this is. Now 1 upon 4. 1 out of 4. 1 out of 4 equal parts. This is the second. And 1 fourth. 1 fourth means 1 quarter. So this is the this part. Okay? Because suppose this is a 1, this is a box. We convert into 4 equal parts. So 1 part we can say 1 upon 4, 1 fourth or 1 quarter also. Okay? So 1 quarter. Now the second question, 2 upon 3. 2 out of 3 equal parts. So this one is, and 2 third. So 2 third. This one is 2 third. Okay? Yes, 2 third. Now 3 upon 8. 3 out of 8 equal parts. This part. And 3 eighths. Where is 3 eighths? This is 3 eighths. Now 3 fourths. So 3 out of 4 equal parts. So 3 fourths. Where is 3 fourths? This is 3 fourths. Okay. Now 1 third. So this is a 1 third. And 1 this one is 1 third. Okay. this question. Now this question number D, fill in the numerator to make a hole. So dear children, to make a hole, what do you mean by hole? Hole से आप क्या समझते हैं? Hole से बेटा जैसे ये 4 है, if we write here 4, तो 4 divided by 4 equal answer is 1. ये जो एक पार्ट क्लियर पार्ट आया ना, तो किसी पार्ट ना तो फ्रैक्शन में डिवाइड हुआ ना डेसिमल में डिवाइड हुआ, एक वो होल नंबर में आया, उसको बोलते से 48/4 भी लिख सकते हैं. 4 × 4 = 4, 2 × 8 टू होल नंबर आ गया. 12 है, हम इसको 12/4 भी लिख सकते हैं. 4 × 4 = 4, 3 × 4 = 3 means यहां 4 भी हो जाएगा, कहने का यहां 4/4 भी हो जाएगा, 8/4 हो सकता है, 12/4 भी हो सकता है, 16/4 भी हो सकता है. मींस 4 से जो नंबर डिविजिबल है वो आपका होल नंबर हो जाएगा. जैसे 6, तो 6 upon 6. अगर आप यहां सपोज थोड़ी देर के लिए 3/6 लिखते हैं, तो 3 × 3, 3 × 2 = 6 = 1/2, ये फ्रैक्शन आ गया. एंड 1/2 मींस हाफ, 1/2 मींस हाफ, तो फिर ये होल नंबर कहां से आया? इसलिए हम यहां पे लिख सकते हैं 6/6, 6 12/6, 18/6, 24/6. ओके, नाउ हियर 3/3, 6/3, 9/3, 12/3, 15/3. ओके, नाउ द फोर्थ क्वेश्चन, 10/10, 20/10, 30/10. ओके, नाउ द लास्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर ई, क्वेश्चन नंबर ई इज फिल इन द डिनोमिनेटर टू मेक अ होल. हियर वी राइट हियर न्यूमरेटर एंड हियर वी राइट हियर डिनोमिनेटर. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज 5/10. सो हियर न्यूमरेटर इज 5, सो हियर डिनोमिनेटर इज ऑल्सो 5. ओके, नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, 3/10, so we write here 3. In the question number 3, 9/10, so denominator is 9. Fourth question, 4/10, here 4/4. Now 4/4. Now 10/10, so we can write here 10/10. Okay, so dear children, this exercise is completed. Now the next time I will tell you exercise 6.2. thank you, have a nice day.